Hi everyone. So we just came back to our hotel after having the breakfast, got freshened up, and now we are on way towards the railway station of Darjeeling because we have a joyride which is scheduled around 12 o'clock. So let's see how the experience goes.
After a brief walk, we reached the Darjeeling railway station that is located at an altitude of 6,801 feet above the mean sea level. In the year of 1999, UNESCO had declared the site of Darjeeling Himalayan Railway as a World Heritage Site. There are in all 9 joyrides that ply between the Darjeeling station and the Ghum station, of which 6 run using the steam engine, while 3 of them run on the diesel engine. We witnessed the departure of one of the joyrides using the steam engine, and ours was next in line. After an interval of half an hour, our train finally bid goodbye to Darjeeling.
Our joyride has started, and you can hear the whistling sound. It's really a nice experience.
During our ride, we passed by some points from where the city of Darjeeling looked amazing. And then we reach our first halt, the Batashelo. The Batashelo is a spiral railway created to lower the gradient of the ascent of the Darjeeling Himalayan Railway.
So we are at Badashia Loop. Our train halted here for 10 minutes. So we'll just check what's up.
The first thing which strikes our eye is the I Love Darjeeling signboard. It's a wonderful place for clicking some amazing pictures. Just beside the signboard, there are some localites who are selling local items and woolen clothes. We are now walking to the memorial of the Gorkha soldiers of the Indian Army who sacrificed their life after Indian independence in 1947. The memorial is centrally located in Batashia Loop. As we roam around the garden, we come across these two little kids who are dressed in traditional clothes and posing around for clicking pictures. After spending few minutes and clicking some pictures of ourselves, we then board the train.
And our journey begins again.
Our train brought us to the Ghum station, and we have 25 minutes break here. There is a museum right next to the station, so we will visit that, and if photography is allowed, then we'll show you also. Come.
The Ghum rail station of Darjeeling Himalayan Railway is the highest railway station in India. It's located at an altitude of 7,407 feet. The museum room is right above the Ghum station, and it is one of the 3 museums of Darjeeling Himalayan Railways. This museum is open between 10 a.m. and 1:30 p.m. and again from 2 p.m. to 4 p.m. and has an entry fee of Rs. 20 per person. But as we had taken up the joyride, this museum's entry was free for us. Inside the museum, we saw many rare photographs of the toy train and also rare and old artifacts of Darjeeling Himalayan Railways. Although the museum is a very small one, but it is definitely worth the watch. And we totally enjoyed browsing through the old collection of rare photographs housed inside this museum. After spending some time here, we walked out of the Ghum Museum in order to witness the oldest steam engine.
Baby Shiva. This was first built in 1881 and then rebuilt in 1999.
We were posing with the star attraction of the Ghum Museum when suddenly we heard the whistle of our steam engine. It was all set to depart from Ghum station and take us back to Darjeeling. This 1.5 hours of train ride will always be cherished by both of us. To continue watching the rest of our journey in Darjeeling, stay tuned to this channel. Thank you for watching.